So let's take a look at a term that Apple has been using a lot recently in their marketing. The term is augmented reality. And very often this is abbreviated simply AR. But what is augmented reality? How is it related to virtual reality? What do you use it for? What equipment do you need to use augmented reality? Well, basically this is a technology right now that's primarily on the iPhone and also on the iPad. And it combines three different elements. The first element is the camera. So this is why it's something that you really need to use on your iPhone or iPad. You need to actually hold a device in front of you. The camera is recording what's in front and just showing it on your screen. The same way when you go to take a picture, you're actually using your screen as a viewfinder. So you look at the screen and your camera looks at the world beyond. So you're kind of looking through, like you would look through binoculars or a telescope or something. But you're looking through your iPhone, looking at the screen, which is showing you what's on the camera on the other side. Now the reason it does this is that it can add something to it, augment the reality that you're seeing. And what it's adding to it is going to be usually 3D graphics. So it's putting a 3D object in the scene. So you may be looking, say, at a table, but it's actually putting a 3D object, like say a chessboard, on the table. It's not really there when you look at the table with your eyes, but when you look through the iPhone's camera, you actually see the object there on the table. It doesn't have to be a 3D object. It could be 2D. It could be like text. It could be labels. For instance, augmented reality might be looking down the street and labels appear in front of each building to tell you what's in them or what the address is or something like that. But there's a third element to it. It's not just static. It's actually live. So there's motion detection here. The idea is as you move your phone and thus the camera and the viewpoint that you're looking at, the objects will react to that. So it's not just taking a static image of a table and putting a chessboard on it. It's actually taking this live image of the table, and as you move the camera around, the object seems to remain in the same place. Here is something that's going to be in iOS 12. It's in the public beta now. It's a measurement app that comes with the iPhone. And basically it shows you what you see through the camera and then it allows you to measure things. And it actually locks onto things. So here it's measuring my whiteboard in my office. This is a very simple application of augmented reality. Apple has a great page that shows you all sorts of videos of examples of things with augmented reality. So you can look through it and you can see some of the examples here. And notice how it's using all three of these objects. It's using the camera. It's using 3D items that are being placed into this reality to augment it. And it's using the motion of the iPhone. So the objects seem to stay in the same place even if your viewpoint is changing slightly. If you want to see more of these examples, just go to the page that Apple's got. It's apple.com/iOS/augmented-reality. And you can go and look at the examples that they've got there. Now with iOS 11 there's already a bunch of different apps that you can search for augmented reality in the App Store. There are a few free ones to try out. A lot of little games, little utilities, things like that. This stuff's going to become more and more common, I think, especially if Apple keeps pushing it like this. And there could be some really interesting uses. And imagine also joint augmented reality. This is going to be something in iOS 12 where you'll actually have two people looking through two different iOS devices but seeing the same object, like say a chessboard or a billiard table in the same location and being able to play a game, interact with virtual objects at the same time through their connected devices.